Hello ladies, how are you all doing? So today I'm here to talk about a very sensitive topic. And it is this question: how does an elegant lady contribute to political or religious topics? Should an elegant lady be contributing to political, religious, controversial topics, trending topics in general? So I'm here to really just talk to you about it and give you my views, my opinions on this. Okay, so the first thing I need you to understand is it's important to know the history behind what you're talking about. Let's use the current situation going on between Russia and Ukraine as an example. The question is, do you really know what is going on? Do you have an in-depth knowledge of what's going on? Or are you just jumping on the trend because everyone is talking about it and you're either feeling like you need to talk about it because it makes you, if not you, you are not that person that cares, or you just want to trend and get likes and what have you, because this is something that people do. Now, one thing I've seen on people's posts, I've seen people say, pray for Ukraine. And that leaves me with a question. Did you actually say a prayer for these people? Because I need you to understand that topics like these are not a joke. It's a serious matter. People are dying. It's very insensitive that you post something just because everyone is talking about it without actually doing anything about it. I personally think you're better off not even posting or talking about it than posting and saying pray for Ukraine, for example, and not actually saying a prayer. That's hypocritical. That means you're just doing things because you want people to see you in a certain way. You must understand that an elegant woman is intentional and she's sensitive. She actually cares about other people, about the people around her. It's never about what people think. It's basically you thinking, is it kind? Is it necessary? And is it the truth? So before you comment, before you post anything, you're thinking of these three things. Is this thing I'm doing kind? Is it necessary? And is it the truth? Am I being true to myself? Or am I doing it because I want to please people? I need you to understand that you also need to move with integrity, honesty, forgiveness, and a lot of love, and no judgment whatsoever. Don't be quick to judge someone because they haven't posted or spoken about this. And I particularly feel sorry for influencers, people who are popular on social media, because for some reason, everybody expects you to be the Messiah, to always talk about everything just because you're in the social eye. And you must understand that these people are human beings as well. They have a right to their opinions. And an elegant lady is gracious enough to understand that you should not force your opinions on people. That it is your opinion does not necessarily make it right. That it is your opinion does not make it the truth. You must remember that it is your opinion, and the fact that you have an opinion means that that other person is also entitled to having an opinion. And you must also remember that talking about these things or posting is not the only way to help. There are charities, people are donating. Some people are not even donating, they're not anything, but they're genuinely on their knees praying, not just for Ukraine, for example, but also for Russia. Because we must understand that the power of God can also stop the attacking country from attacking, okay? And this is why it's important that we don't always act based on our emotions. I understand that as women, we can be very emotional, and it's not a crime to be emotional. But it becomes a problem when you're not in control of your emotions. And then it causes a trigger whereby you're, you know, becoming this person that is attacking everyone who doesn't agree with your views. And another thing is you must also consider that And this is one thing I'll say to influencers, people that are popular on social, you must understand that whatever you say, people are going to have an opinion. So if you say this, they will hate you. If you say that, they will hate you. If you don't say anything, they will hate you. And this is why it's important that you are assertive. Know why you're doing what you're doing. You must be bold enough and strong enough to understand that being in the public eye, unfortunately, attracts a lot of hate. It makes people believe that they automatically have the right to talk to you and tell you what to do. But you mustn't always bend to the tune of everyone. You must understand that you are in a place of influence. So there are people watching you. And to become a leader, to become a successful person, you must be able to take the throws, the blows that come at you without bending into doing something that you shouldn't be doing. Now you must understand that political talks, for example, can cause a lot of division, because for a lot of people, it's very personal and it can, you know, become, it can really escalate quickly. So this is why I advise that you be very careful, especially if you don't know the history, you don't have enough knowledge about it. Now the question is, I'm at work and someone really wants to talk about this, or they are always just coming into my face on social media, somebody's just there commenting. How do you respond? It's okay. So for example, say, let's say this person has, you know, aired their opinion. You must understand that you airing yours might just escalate the whole thing. So you could just say, I can understand why you feel this way, and I pray that we get a solution to this soon. Now, this statement basically says, I'm not agreeing with you and I'm not disagreeing. Now, you must also understand that sometimes it's better to be quiet, because what you haven't said cannot be used against you. And just like I said with the response I gave earlier, where I said, you can simply say that I can understand why you feel this way, and, you know, I pray that we find a solution to this soon. You haven't really said anything. You haven't supported or gone against. So again, what you have not said cannot be used against you. That something is trending doesn't mean that there's an obligation for you to talk about it. Don't try to become an expert on something that you don't have enough information about. Because while you're trying to sound intelligent, while you're trying to appeal to everyone and seem like a nice person, you might end up looking stupid and embarrassing yourself. And this is why it's important that you are assertive and you know exactly what you're saying and why you're saying it. So what I'm trying to say at the end of the day, ladies, is when there is a trending topic, when there is a sensitive topic, politics, religion, whatever it is, you must be very careful. An elegant lady is intelligent. She's sensitive. She's gracious. She's forgiving. She's not judgmental. And you must understand that everyone should be allowed to express their opinions, their feelings, their emotions, how they deem fit. There is nothing gracious about forcing your opinions down someone's throat, about forcing someone to do something because you think they're in the public eye. That they are in the public eye does not make them an authority in every single thing that is going on. So ladies, it's important that we apply diplomacy when we're dealing with sensitive topics. It could be anything at all. It could be a riot. It could be anything at all going on. But once it's trending, especially when it's something that has to do with lives, that has to do with the matters of the heart, that has to do with more people than yourself, it's advisable that you keep quiet if you don't have enough information, and not just that saying things or doing things because you want to impress people. Like I said, if you put up pray for these people, ensure that you're praying. An elegant lady is not pretentious. You're not trying to do things because you want people to think you're nice. You're actually doing things because you are kind. Your heart has been worked on. And remember, or that someone has an opinion about something doesn't necessarily make them right. You are a human being. I am a human being. And we are all entitled to doing things the way we think is best for us. Remember, is it true? Is it necessary? Okay? And is it kind? Thank you so much, ladies, for watching today. And I hope to see you soon.